gonna do this tuna up. Just caught it about 3 hours ago. It's been hanging, been bleeding out. And clean it, we're gonna clean it, and then we're gonna prep it, and then we're gonna smoke it. And then after that, hopefully eat it. So the first part, hot water in a bucket down here. And we're just going to put the whole tuna inside. We're going to split it open from the back. Okay, from the back. We're going to take the spine out so that the tuna is opened up like that, and you get a wider piece as opposed to coming from the belly. So we're not going to cut the belly. We're going to cut the backbone out. So I'll start off, and then we'll time lapse the rest. Now this is the trickiest part, is to take, split it open. Now I'm going to take the backbone off. I usually come from this side and then peel it off that way rather than come from this side. Well, I'll go from both sides anyway. Yeah, it's just trying to leave there as much meat on as I can. So I'm going to go from both sides.
tuna. Leave the fat on. Not my best, but good enough. So you can see how wide it is now, the tuna. And those can be steaked up as well when we smoke them. But we're going to salt them now and then put them in the smoker. Okay, we're going to salt it now, put the toti on, and I don't hang my tuna up to dry. The moisture's already in there, so when I smoke it, it's still moist. Cut them up and chuck them straight into the smoker. So I'll see you down at the smoker. Right, so here we are at the smoker. So this is just a normal, one of the old clothes dryers back in the days, and I just converted it into a smoker. So you've got your trays there, and then I got this for a bit of moisture just so it won't dry out, and then. And there's some wood chips, been soaking in some water. Wood chips, bit of sawdust on top of that. And this here prevents it from drying too much. And then the rest here, we're gonna slap probably in here, the tuna, around the back here. Got the gas, I'll cut a hole in the back. Just put a two ring burner in there, gas burner. So locked up the holes as much as you could, and then it's away. So I'm gonna put baking paper on here so it doesn't stick to the trays. I tried everything, oiling the trays and it still sticks, so I'm gonna try baking paper now. See if that works. Hopefully it doesn't burn. Sweet. Alright, okay. So you'll notice I left the tinu on there, the fat. So that's always good, leaving the fat on there. Just a small tuna, enough to feed the whānau. Okay, so finally got it going, and that's sitting there like that. So it's on. We'll come back in about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours, to see how she's going. It's only a small tuna. And then we'll see the difference. Okay, right, back again. It's been about an hour and 40 minutes. Let's see how the progress of this tuna, smoking the tuna, has been going. Slow brown on there, and yeah, probably leave it in for maybe another hour, maybe another 2 hours. See how it goes till it goes brown. All right, moment of truth. We're going to pull out the tuna, and it's been in there for maybe about 4 hours. So obviously we've been smashing back the back bones because they don't take much to cook. And you see down the bottom, the water's almost run out, so that's the amount of water. And we're just going to pull some of these out and see what it looks like. Tiny helpers. Sweet. All the baking paper worked. But pretty good, not as bad. Yeah, pretty good. Just pull this whole thing off. There you go, get that out. That's the head, and then the rest. This should just come together. There you go, baking paper works. Boom. Let's go and do the taste test. Taste test. Still moist. Lovely. Right. There you go. Smoked tuna.